All right, coming up next, it's a bantamweight matchup between Sugar Sean O'Malley and Cody Garbrandt. All right, here he is, the Team Alpha Male staple, the former UFC bantamweight champion, Cody No Love Garbrandt. He was 11-0 when he beat Dominick Cruz to win the belt back in 2016. Some recent adversity for Cody No Love, but this is a special athlete who most people believe will eventually get on track.
Cody Garbrandt is a guy that has competed in so many sports at such a high level.
Yes.
He was a state champion wrestler, was a state champion football player, but then decided he was going to focus on boxing. Became a Golden Gloves champion, a guy that has all the ability to once again hold the UFC championship.
How about Cody Garbrandt playing middle linebacker, 135 pounds in the state of Ohio?
In Ohio.
Tells you all you need to know about Cody Garbrandt back on the Proven Ground here tonight. Well, always exciting when this guy shows up on the fight card, Daniel. He is a true mixed martial artist. Not really any glaring weaknesses, at least, that he's put on film thus far.
He's the new breed of fighter. Those kids that start doing everything at 6 years old. They start wrestling. They start doing jiu-jitsu. They start to box. He's one of those guys that has every one of those skills, and he does them all at an A-plus level. He's got tremendous cardio. He is the type of fighter that in a few years will just litter the UFC roster across the board.
And oftentimes his opponents will say he doesn't really do anything special, but he does everything at a plus level, and he believes he'll have a lot of advantages in this matchup tonight. All right, now our tale of the tape for this bantamweight scrap. 4 years apart, with some differences in height, but big differences in reach. Here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Eve Loving. Is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the sold-out T-Mobile Arena in Las Vegas, it's time! 5 rounds in the UFC bantamweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a freestyle fighter, holding a professional record of 12 wins, 4 losses. He stands 5 feet 8 inches tall, weighing in at 135 pounds. Fighting out of Sacramento, California, Cody No Love Garbrandt. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a mixed martial artist, holding a professional record of 14 wins, 1 loss. He stands 5 feet 11 inches tall, weighing in at 135 pounds. Fighting out of Glendale, Arizona, USA, Sugar Sean O'Malley.
Okay, guys, protect yourself at all time. Obey my command at all time. If you want to touch love, do it now. Go back to your point.
Ready?
All right, crowd getting excited as this fight gets underway. And you hate to call any fighter on this UFC roster a specialist. But on one side, you have a definite striker taking on a true 5-2.
And you see a guy in the striker who knows exactly who he is. He knows where the fight needs to be. He knows what he has to do in order to be successful. Let's see if he can keep his opponent off of it.
Man, he's just got a great feel for the striking realm early in this one.
The timing is on point. He's doing a great job of mixing everything up. Ooh, what a punch.
Well, you see him land the jab there. He's got the reach advantage and might as well use it. And he landed the right hand there. Both guys throwing potential fight enders here in the early going. Just misses with the left hook. Ooh. Oh, straight right. All right, so 1 minute in, he looked like it did stall him a little bit.
Dude's hurt. Serve him up. Go get him.
Big knee to the body.
Looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
All right, so inside the open guard of his opponent, you got to be careful playing around for too long here on the ground with this guy. Strong bottom work here, staying busy. Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining.
Oh, Malley gets caught with that punch. He's treading water now. Got to find a way to move those feet. 2 minutes have expired off the first round clock. Oh, look at that jab. Snapped his head, man.
What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this moment. Go finish this fight. He got him.
And now he lands a combination.
Dig and kick. That one was thrown to end the fight.
Yep. Garbrandt's lower jaw now starting to show signs of swelling. Unable to land with that punch. So he's really starting to put together some significant body shots here. These are going to take their toll as this fight goes on.
I mean, he's cutting down the size with these beautiful leg kicks.
Stuffs that takedown attempt without issue. O'Malley gets caught with that punch. Not the easiest guy in the world to hit, but he got caught there. Level stuff as he counters with that right hand. All right, he lands a hook there, DC. Now we'll see if he can follow it up.
When you throw a hook, it can go around the guard of your opponent. Oh, nice.
Garbrandt's strike there is blocked. Nice job by the defense. Well, we talked about his reach advantage off the top. Made good use of it there with that punch, DC.
Big, powerful punch lands. Now he gets back to range.
Oh, and he lands yet another strike to the body. Pinpoint placement right underneath the elbow. Spinning back fist.
Gotta check these low leg kicks.
So we cross the 30-second mark in our opening round. Good defense to block the strike coming back. And they separate. Oh, and he tags him with the straight hand there. Beautifully done by Garber.
That one snuck in. Nice strike. You don't know when that leg kick's coming.
All right, he engages in a single collar tie here. Horn sounds for the end of round one.
Let's recompose.
Second round here.
Liver kicks. If you take those kicks, it's going to shut your body off. Still nice body.
Garbrandt gets caught with that punch. Just out of range with that right hand. Slips the punch. Trying the flying knee there. And he continues to work the body here.
Look at the force behind that leg kick.
Good series of strikes for him there, staying busy and staying accurate.
I mean, the accuracy is unbelievable. Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one up?
Looking to land the right just out of range. Wow!
Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's gotta press him. He's gotta go chase that finish down now.
Oh, he might be out. Nice counter left there. Oh, nice job to land the straight punch there. Must be nice to have that kind of reach advantage, DC. I know you can't necessarily relate. Garbrandt gets caught with that punch.
That was a thudding leg kick.
All right, so he's landed some good shots. You hate to be overly critical, but nothing really in terms of combinations tonight.
Well, the jab has been looking great. How about jab, jab, right hand?
Right.
Because eventually you're gonna have to put something on your opponent that's gonna really make him pause. I believe the jab has been working so well, if he drops a big right hand after it, he may be able to finish the fight.
O'Malley gets hit by that leg kick.
Oh, big punch land.
Garbrandt gets touched by that kick to the body. Well, he was a little bit lackluster in round one. You can't say the same here in this second round. He has really picked up the pace, an uptick in the aggression and the output, and starting to find his range here in the pocket. Takedown defense holds up.
Nice punch here. He's throwing every part of himself into these big leg kicks.
Well, lands a kick there, pretty well done.
Really good accuracy landing that kick.
Ooh-wee!
Ooh-wee, what a right hand by this young man.
All right, so a seminal blow earlier in the round. It wasn't a knockdown, but it was certainly a stunner that caught his attention.
Oh, I mean, he got hurt bad. To see him still standing, that just goes to the toughness that he has to be still standing after taking such a damaging shot.
He's going after the head.
Can't take many of those. You better check.
O'Malley gets hit with that hook. That one had some pop behind it. Flips the guard, lands the right hand. Oh, nice combination there by Sean O'Malley. He missed with that jab attempt there. They continue to exchange.
Let's go, you can do this.
Oh, misses with the jab.
Look at him drive his shin into the opponent's body with that body kick.
Wild attempt with the right hand there.
Come on, buddy. Keep your hands up. Let's go.
Look at him whip his hip into that kick.
All right, so a good series of kicks by him there. He has mixed it up beautifully, I think, on the feet tonight.
He is kicking everywhere tonight. He's doing a fantastic job.
Man, looks like he's trying to set records here, landing all of these strikes. He is aggressive to a fault and really has been all night long as he continues to pour it on. Got to be careful here, though, not to gas out. Oh, that right hand is on point. Just out of range with that left hook.
Look at how he turns his hip over and he throws that kick.
Oh, rips the body shot there.
Oh,
Whoa! How about those 5 minutes? All right, so the round is over, but not before damage was done. Cut on the cheek sustained in that round. Cutman in there quickly as usual to try to seal it up. All right, a lot of high-level highlights from that last round, DC. Take us through the replay.
If he fought like this, I would be comfortable entering him into a K-1 level kickboxing competition. He's that good at finding and landing those kicks at will. He needs to continue to do this as the fight goes on.
All right, DC, buckle up. Here we go with our next round. High number of kicks landed in the previous round, and he'll look to keep it going here.
He'll look to keep winning the fight with his kicks. He's throwing high kicks, leg kick, body kick. He's even throwing a couple spin kicks in there. This guy is so educated with fighting with his legs.
Well, he hasn't really showed any signs of slowing down tonight. He continues to connect on a high volume of strikes here.
Nice punch from that.
Oh, combination lands. You want to talk about putting strikes together. Beautiful execution.
And every one of them are landing. He's overwhelming him with different attacks. Who's hurt? Serve him up. Go get him.
Well, he's up, but he is hurting for certain. The finish could come at any time. Oh, nice job to block the kick. Man, look at the redness now almost immediately on the right side of his body. Oh, you can feel that Breeze octagon side after the swing and a miss by Garber.
Look at how he turns his hip into that leg kick.
Just missed with the left there. Starting to do some really significant damage to the body here. Another strike lands there.
Big punch land. Boom.
Yeah, looks a little wobbly on his feet.
He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
Oh, he might be out. Stuffs the takedown there. How good is his takedown defense? Lands with the kick there. No pad on that foot.
No shin guards. He's taking all of that kick every time he throws it.
Well, you got to think he's going to enjoy watching this one back tomorrow morning. He has landed a ton of significant strikes, and really a guy who has been a monster in the gym finally putting it together here in the octagon.
To go home and admire your work, it doesn't take till the next morning. He's going back to school right now and firing up the video to look at beauty in action. And he was the one causing all the action.
All right, so he connects with another punch there. Kind of targeting that cut, I think.
I mean, when you get a cut on your opponent and you see it and it's pouring blood, you continue to attack it. Every time you land, you can see that it splits it a little bit more. Great job finding that weakness and really taking advantage of it.
Hands on your face.
Great punch.
Well, this is exactly the sense of urgency you're looking for. Try to take the judges out of it. He is lighting them up now. Oh, caught him with a head kick. That at least partially landed.
Oh, my goodness. He got kicked in the head, and he's still standing. Big kick.
Garbrandt's lower jaw is extremely swollen now.
Oh! Didn't like that left hand. What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this move. Go finish this fight.
Went for the inside leg kick. Oh, lands another shot to the body, beautifully placed as he continues to punish his opponent's midsection here in this round.
Good punch. Jeez Louise.
That strike blocked by Gold.
Big knee! He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
Oh! Well, he has certainly found the range and staying pretty busy here on the feet.
He's being busy, but it's also the timing and the accuracy that's allowing him to land so many attacks.
Wow.
As he gets close and he's out of the kicking range, he'll change his stance. Bad, John. He's got to press him. He's got to go chase that finish down now. Oh, no!
Game of inches right there, boy. Wow.
What a fight so far. All right, that's the end of the round. He's got a cut on his cheek from that round. There are certainly worse locations for a cut on the cheek. It's not going to trickle down into the eye. Nonetheless, pretty significant gash. We'll see if the cut man can close it up. All right, let's check out some of the action from that previous round, DC, and what a display on the feet. Huge knockdown with that kick.
Yeah, he's a high-level striker. He throws these kicks to the body. He throws them low, but when he goes up top, he's very powerful, and he can end anybody's night. The toughness displayed by his opponent allowed him to stay in the fight, but he cannot take many more of those types of strikes.
Able to check the high kick. O'Malley gets tattooed by that stiff jab. Well, not much setup behind it. The right hook misses. And he connects with a punch there. We'll see if he can follow it up. Oh! Ooh, diving punch lands.
Dude's hurt. Serve him up. Go get him.
All right, so you got to be careful playing on the ground with this guy. You don't want to mess around for too long. Close guard. O'Malley's attempting to pass here, but he's denied by the defense. Bottom fighter trying to control posture, unable to do so.
And now he's in a lot of danger. He's got to grab that head or he's going to get blasted.
Oh, his opponent's squirming like a fish out of water now. The ground and pound is on point. This could very well be the beginning of the end.
This could be the beginning of the end. We've seen some really good ground and pound fighters. This young man is as good as any we've ever seen.
Punches in bunches, and he hasn't really shown any signs of slowing down here tonight. I'm not sure how much more his opponent can take. Garbrandt gets hit with a kick. Big shots being landed on both sides here. Oh! Well, anytime you are in a ground fighting situation with this fighter, you're potentially playing with fire. Posturing up now.
And now the damage is about to start.
Pretty good. That is it. And that's gonna do it.
Unbelievable.
Oh, absolutely one for the highlight reel right there. A tremendous kick to spell the end of the night for his opponent and for him, I should say, but just caught him flush full force. Beautiful extension on the kick, and the fight was really over as soon as that one made contact. I'm not even sure he was conscious when he hit the canvas. Outstanding performance here tonight. Send it inside the octagon to Bruce Buffer for the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eve Levine has called a stop to this contest at 2:04 of round number 4. Declaring the winner by knockout, Sugar Sean O'Malley.
Well, he's smiling ear to ear, and why not after a knockout like that? I need to take it to the after party tonight.
I mean, this is what dreams are made of. You dream of the knockout like this, and then the party after, where you and all your coaches get to celebrate the great handiwork.